Once home to Michael Jackson, this 4-bedroom and 4.5-bath condo is located on New York City's Fifth Avenue and benefits from spectacular views over Central Park through its floor-to-ceiling windows. Situated on the 63rd floor of the Trump Tower, the apartment is just a couple floors down from Donald Trump's very own $100 million penthouse. Once home to the billionaire's parents, Fred and Mary, Trump rented the pad out for 10 months to his pal Michael Jackson for $110,000 a month back in the summer of 1994, after he secretly married his then-new bride, Lisa Marie Presley. Some residents said that Jackson rented this property in particular because it allowed him to go in the elevator directly to the garage and leave stealthily out the building, avoiding mass hysteria from fans and paparazzi on the streets of New York.
This is what the richest newlyweds in America now call home. A skyscraper as big as their marriage, the extravagant Trump Tower in New York. Donald Trump owns the place, of course, and his friendship with Michael Jackson goes way back. Trump even has a picture of the King of Pop and Donald's kids prominently displayed in his living room.
I think it's great. They're very happy, and I think everybody's happy. They're great people.
You must have kept this secret for a long time.
I've known the secret for a long time, for a very long time.
Spanning 3,725 square feet, this grand-scale, customized residence features a grand living room, cherry-paneled library, black absolute granite and marble gallery. The master bedroom suite features a private dressing room, an ensuite onyx bathroom, and expensive closets. There are lots and lots of rooms. Among the many features of this many-featured home are electric blinds, a private home office, professional park-facing chef's kitchen, a large laundry room, and 28 windows that offer north, south, and west-facing views over Manhattan. You yourself could even enjoy Michael Jackson's former New York crash pad, who even turned one of the bedrooms into a mirror dance studio for a cool $23 million when it was put back on the market in 2016. Trump himself claimed the singer was a very good friend of his, writing in Time after the King of Pop's death in 2009, "He was an amazing guy, but beyond all else, he was the greatest entertainer I've ever known."
Well, I knew Michael very well, and he was a special guy. He was with me many, many times, at Mar-a-Lago in particular, in Palm Beach. Michael did a lot for charity, and if I ever needed him for something, if he had to come, like tonight, to Police Athletic League, not that he was thrilled about it, because the last 10 years were tough for him, but he'd always be there.
The tycoon also told previously CNN he lived in Trump Tower. He lives in various of my buildings. He sort of follows me around in the sense that he likes what I have. Mr. Trump first met Michael Jackson in 1988 when he attended a Madison Square Garden concert that was part of the singer's tour in support of his Bad album. After the show, the current president of the United States made a backstage visit to the King of Pop, and they apparently hit it off. In 1990, Mr. Trump even persuaded Michael Jackson to show up at the opening of the Trump Taj Mahal in Atlantic City, parading him in front of camera crews and reporters. The next day, Mr. Jackson's close friend, Ryan White, succumbed to the AIDS virus, and the developer accompanied him on a visit to the grieving family in Indianapolis, with press and photographers in tow. After Mr. Jackson moved into his Trump Tower apartment, the business mogul took him to a low-key dinner at Le Cirque. "There was no entourage, no posse," said Mario Wehner, the restaurant's longtime maitre d'hotel. He came as a guest of Mr. Trump, and that was it. Michael Jackson barely touched his risotto, Mr. Wehner recalled, and Mr. Trump had fish and drank no alcohol.
Since they returned to the United States, the reclusive couple has spent most of their time in New York. The wacky pair was spotted here at FAO Schwartz, Lisa Marie pushing a disguised Michael in a wheelchair.
Much like the King of Pop, the President of the United States, Donald Trump, doesn't really do subtle, and his landmark Trump Tower is no exception. Boasting a grand gold atrium waterfall made largely of Italian Brecci Pernice marble and with retail tenants that eventually included Gucci, Landel Jewelry, and the Trump Store, the building is not exactly homey. Donald Trump's former primary residence is a three-story penthouse apartment estimated at more than 10,000 square feet by Forbes. Originally designed by Halston's interior designer Angelo Donghia, it had a smoky Helmut Newton vibe, with black lacquered walls, velvet furniture, and handsome mid-century tables. A private elevator connects Mr. Trump to the 26th floor office where he conducted Trump Organization business. Then Mr. Trump went to the nearby Olympic Tower for a dinner held by the Saudi billionaire Adnan Khashoggi, encountered a living room bigger than his own, and decided to remodel. Out went the mirrors, brass and mahogany. In came the Greek columns, gold leaf paint, and Louis XIV inspired furniture. A style much preferred by Michael Jackson and appears to be reflected in his own Trump Tower apartment. However, Michael Jackson wasn't Trump's only famous resident to have called Trump Tower their New York home. Over the years, the list of other rich and famous residents reads like a who's who of New York society. Work on the Gleaming Tower began in 1980, replacing a 12-story Bun with Teller store, a stately structure built as Stewart & Company in 1929. At a cost of $190 million, just before the tower's sumptuous apartments first hit the market, it was reported that Prince Charles and his new wife, Princess Diana, had their eyes on the place as a bold hole in New York. In the words of today's Trump, it proved to be fake news, but the tycoon turned the false alarm to his advantage. The sale that never occurred, as Mr. Trump called it in The Art of the Deal, but was the one that most helped Trump Tower. Trump Tower at 721 to 725 Fifth Avenue opened to the public February 1983. By this time, more than half the building's condominium units had been sold, and all but a small percentage would be gone within the next few years.
The Trump Tower, when it's completed, will be $400 million worth of high-priced apartments, commercial space, and boutiques.
What's happened is phenomenal. I've never seen anything to the extent that I have in New York. It now, from a real estate standpoint, has probably become the hottest city in the world. People are flocking here by droves. And I guess a lot of things had to do with it. Mostly, I feel, it was the psychology of making New York a winner as opposed to a loser.
Soon, show business stars were beating a path to the skyscraper. In that first decade, the actor Bruce Willis, singer Paul Anka, and entertainer Liberace all bought apartments. Willis eventually put his on the market for $12 million in 2005. British composer and impresario Andrew Lloyd Webber sold his 5,300-square-foot apartment on the 59th and 60th floors for an eye-watering $14 million in 2010. In August last year, soccer player Cristiano Ronaldo spent $18.5 million on an apartment in the famous building. Given Mr. Trump's feuds with celebrities such as Rosie O'Donnell and Snoop Dogg, it may not come as a surprise that some of his relationships with well-known tenants ended poorly. Another early resident was the chat show host Johnny Carson, but he left under a cloud in 1987 following a row over a missing coat. Two Trump employees who were accused of stealing the garment were duly sacked, only for Carson to later shamefacedly admit that he found it among his belongings.
But Jennifer, don't worry about Jennifer Flowers. She got a new job. She got fired, you know. She was a receptionist at an unemployment agency. She got canned, but she got a new job today as a Donald Trump backup mistress. That's right. That's right. If for any reason Marla Maples is unable to fulfill her duties, Jennifer steps in.
Renting on the same floor as Jackson was career criminal Jay Weinberg, who was convicted in the late 1980s of one of the biggest medical care frauds in U.S. history. The same pad was then sold to Vadim Trincher, a Russian-born poker champion, for $4 million in 2009. 4 years later, he was convicted of running a gambling ring catering to Russian mobsters and sentenced to 5 years. Recent residents of the 62nd and 63rd floors also include Guido Lombardi, a Palm Beach socialite originally from Trieste, Italy, Trump supporter and U.S. representative of the anti-immigrant Northern League political party in his homeland. Hillary Clinton even used the building as a residence. The year was 2000, and Mrs. Clinton was in the middle of her first political campaign, running to be New York's junior senator. Steven Spielberg, an enthusiastic donor to Mrs. Clinton's campaign, had use of a pied-à-terre in Trump Tower purchased for him by Universal Pictures, but barely stayed at the place despite its views of Central Park, and offered it to the candidate as a crash pad on grueling campaign days. Donald J. Trump and Mrs. Clinton were on good terms back then. He donated money to her candidacy and called her tough and smart. Moreover, Mr. Trump was skilled in the art of spinning his associations with celebrities into publicity. However, few tenants attracted as much publicity for the building as Michael Jackson.
Michael Jackson was actually a very good friend of mine. I knew Michael Jackson very well, lived in Trump Tower for a long period of time, would go down to Mar-a-Lago. He actually got married, you know, Lisa Marie Presley, the whole big deal at Mar-a-Lago. They were in the tower. And I will tell you, he was up there 1 week with her and he never came down. So I don't know what was going on, but they got along. You know, a lot of people say, oh, they didn't really. They were up there for a week. They never, ever came down. I said, where the hell is Michael? I've never seen Michael. But he was a very talented guy, one of the truly most talented people. I knew him very well. I knew the real story of Michael Jackson. You know, when he died, I would watch people get on. I don't want to mention names, but people that you know very well, and people that you interview, and they would talk about Michael Jackson. They didn't even know him. I mean, very few people got to know Michael Jackson.
Click here to learn more about Michael Jackson and Donald Trump's unlikely friendship. Or alternatively, check out our other Michael Jackson home tours. Thank you for watching The Detail. We'll see you next time.